today to talk to you about my latest collection, Jelly and Jam. The collection will be in stores April 2024, but we're showing it to you now so that you can see all of the goodies coming up. This is the collection, and let me see if I can bring that up a little bit closer to you guys. It has the full palette of kind of that spring feeling garden with the taupes and the grays, a couple of different tones, really good ones, of greens, aqua, red, coral, my favorite kind of peachy pink, and then the creams. And so there's that great bundle, that great fabric on the top. So that's the full collection. And today I'm going to show you the quilts that all accompany it. First up is the quilt behind me. It's called Coventry, and it's my take on a British countryside inn armoire. It's filled with mason jars and chintz porcelain pitchers and jams and jellies, jarred goods. It's set up in rows, in four rows that are meant to look like shelves. And in the pattern, there's a sampler, and I'm gonna show you a mini and a table runner in a second. The blocks repeat, so everything is not individual, so you basically can make them in sets. The pattern is set up by block, and we did a similar setup on a pattern this last year called Fairy Tale Pumpkins, where we did a sampler, a table runner, and a mini, and it was one of our most popular fall patterns, so we decided to do that kind of setup again. It gives people the opportunity to go to do bigger or smaller depending on what they want to work on. So like I mentioned, it's all done by rows. It's also in flip piecing the way that we love to do. No specialty rulers or paper piecing or anything like that. I would say a confident beginner could definitely work on this block by block. So that's the sampler. And if you can see this right here, this is the mini version. Or the little table topper, and it has just a sampling of some of the blocks in it, that the pitcher and the mason jar with the little strawberry. And it's a perfect little table topper for your kitchen or for your wall. And then here in front of me is the table runner, which is a longer version of one of the rows with a few more goodies in it, a few more items. So it could be for a little breakfast nook or something. That's a perfect project if you love all of the goodies in there, but you don't really want to commit to the full sampler. You get a little bit of everything in the table runner. All of those can be made with fat quarters or quarter yards. So it's a really good scrap project, both to work on with like a fat quarter tower of jelly and jam, or from scraps from your favorite local quilt shop. Next up is Dragonfly. So this time around in the collection, we have almost each pattern is a slightly different format. So that first one that I was talking about has the one of the three different items in it. This next one, the Dragonfly, once I started playing with the block, there were so many different versions and varieties that I could make with it that I couldn't just pick one. That happens to me sometimes, where I just can't cope with picking one and leaving all the others out. And so we actually made it into a book or a booklet that will have four different designs, two different size blocks. Some of them can be made with a layer cake. Some of them are two color. So for that will be more seasonal. So let me show you the first one. This is the main one that's done with a layer cake. Let's see if I can bring it up higher to show you guys. So that's the bigger size of the two blocks, and this is made for the layer cake, and so you just get a little bit of everything in the whole collection. And the blocks are just set in a straight setting facing the same direction, right? So that's, as you can see, it's not even bound yet. It's that new and fresh from the quilter. I'll show you guys the quilting on these things up close in a separate video, so if you're interested for that one, then look for that one separately. And as you can see, I'm just gonna hold this one here so you can see the difference in scale. This is the smaller block in the quilt, and it's done seasonally, and the blocks are then turned into wreaths, and it immediately creates a different pattern. So this is the smaller block versus the one behind me. It's a little awkward, but I don't know if you can see the difference between the two in terms of the size. So let me turn this one and put this one over here. And this is all the reds and greens from the collection. So it is very much a spring collection, but as if you have followed me for a while, you know I love to pull out a few different colors from the group and make something that looks completely different. So this is basically turned it into a Christmas quilt from a spring collection, which I love. All the reds, all the greens. And again, like I was mentioning, same block, turned in circles, creates these great wreath patterns. And in the book, you can also do this with the bigger size. You can do this with the layer cake and keep all of the colors and make it a garden wreath. So there's one in there that's a garden wreath pattern. And we're working on another Christmas one where all of the blocks are gonna go in diagonal rows that are alternating reds and greens. So for another completely Christmas feeling pattern all in one in that booklet. So I'm gonna put this guy over there. Okay, next up is mosaic. And this can be done either with, for a larger block with a layer cake, or a smaller block with two charm packs. And I love to have a design in each collection that really just showcases a little, you know, the whole collection in a block that really does that. And I feel like this really does. This is the one made with a layer cake. And as you can see, you get a little bit of everything. It's, again, our simple sew and flip piecing that makes up all of these blocks. So really an accessible pattern. And this has my favorite cream floral on the border and one of my favorite little ginghams there that's got the pink gingham as the binding. The one before this had the green gingham as the binding, and the one coming up is going to have the red gingham as the binding. I think maybe you might sense a theme on that. So that was made with a layer cake, but it can also be made in a smaller version with two charm packs. Next up is plumeria, and this is probably my favorite block that I've designed in a long time. This first one that I'm showing you is, I pulled out all the corals and kind of the peachy pinks and greens and tans to create kind of a garden version of the quilt, and that's the larger of the blocks. And there it is in kind of a garden feel. And I love how the block looks graphic and modern, but also gardeny, and it looks like a flower. I really am liking it. This, if you can see, well, it's probably gonna be hard to show you the wonderful quilting on some of these. Like I said, I'll show you guys that in a separate video, but this has got some wonderful custom quilting on it. So this one was all done with yardage. The same quilt can be done out of a dessert roll. And we have one in there with a slightly smaller block. And I'll show you what it looks like inversed and done with two colors. So this is the same exact block, but the block is done in cream and the background is the color. It uses one of the eyelets, our Fig Tree Basic eyelets. This uses the softer red, but I'm kind of envisioning it in every single one of the eyelet fabrics. I feel like it would be so beautiful with a yellow or a blue, patriotic or caramel one for the fall. This is gonna be my new favorite Christmas quilt, I believe. Here, let me see if I can show you guys a little bit more of it. So that's for the scale, so you can see what that one looks like. And again, that one's not bound either, yet. So that's it for the fabric, the pattern releases with this collection. We have one more special goodie. I've teamed up with Fat Quarter Shop and their publishing branch, It's So Emma, and we have we are going to offer one of our standalone block of the month from Fig Tree. It's called Strawberry Garden, and it's a program that we've done before that we are now going to offer in a book with It's So Emma. And this is the original one that I did several years ago out of strawberry and rhubarb. So the new sampler in the book will be made all out of jelly and jam, and it will have several companion projects with it. Four quilts, a table runner, and a tabletopper, I believe. And this is, let me see if I can open this up so you can see a little bit more of it. So that's the sampler. And it's one of our kind of super scrappy, soft, romantic samplers. It's one of the ones that we've gotten the most requests for over the last couple of years. So we thought we would pair up with It's So Emma again and put it into a book with some complimentary patterns that go with it. It will all be out of, or based in jelly and jam with some eyelet and some other little things added in, but primarily jelly and jam. So I think that is all the quilt goodies. I have some other small things I want to show you guys from the collection, and I will do that in a separate video. So I hope you have enjoyed watching the jelly jam release. Thanks, you guys. It's still going.